Are we live now or what? What's going on?
I think we're live.
I think we're live. Anyways, guys, this is Tommy Barricade. I am the ROC ambassador to the Hangouts. Our show follows the ETR show. Did you guys watch the ETR show?
Mm-hmm.
Fucking great. No. Fucking great. Awesome job, man. No. That was great. You guys could have went on forever and ever and ever. I'd be fucking passed out on my couch and I would never be in the fucking Hangout.
Yeah, you gotta nip it in the bud.
Yeah, no doubt, eh? So anyways, like I said, we're this is the ROC Hangout, and we got a bunch of jackals already up in here. You can catch us on YouTube, which we are right now. You guys are watching. We have the Twitter account, which is Enter the Rock. We have Facebook. Just type in Realm of Collectors. We're there. And on IG, we got Realm of Collectors on IG. You fucking find us there all the time. We're always posting pics and hashtagging this and hashtagging that and whatnot. So, you know, it's really growing. I've noticed that it's really growing. The family is really growing. It's getting up in numbers and shit, man. Like, look how far we've gone already. You guys have done a really good job. You know, all the guys that started the shit, you know, Eddie, Chris.
Nah.
Rolling Steel. Got to get Rolling Steel in there, too.
We've done a good job, man. We've, as a family, we together. We've done a really good time, man.
Yeah, it's nice to see that, man. It's great. So anyways, I got a couple of co-hosts that are here with me. We've got Asian Kid Matt, and we got Jose. So I'm going to pass this off to one of those guys. Jose.
Oh, got passing over, Matt. Oh, that's what you get for going to the Justin Bieber concert, motherfucker.
That's for telling us that fuck, we should get Justin Bieber back as Canadians.
Yep, we
don't want him either.
Now you have to fucking deal with your penance, man. Pay your penance.
You know, Jillybot had the greatest time. You can see her face and she's smiling and everything. Matt's all like... All right.
What's up, guys? We'll take us into some intros. I'm going to go from left to right on my screen. So I'm going to start with my co-host, Asian Kid Matt. What's up, brother?
Oh, hey, what's up, everybody?
Tell us what you got this week, if you got anything.
He's got something.
Doors go up. I got my Lambo doors.
No. Lambo door.
Okay, I got the
door. One. Door.
One. It took me 6 hours, so that's fine, but I'll get the other one on eventually.
Eventually?
Yeah, eventually.
You should be out there doing it now. I'd be that type of guy. I need to get it done now.
Get it done.
Yeah. Did you get any Transformers this week? Anything?
No, but I got a bunch of Civil War stuff. I got the Civil War Legos. I have every single one of them that were in the movie now, including Spider-Man.
Are they legit or KO?
They are legit. I went with legit this time, yep.
Okay, well, this time. He said this. He said this time.
And, of course, I got some more LEDs. Yeah, that's about it.
All right.
Sweet. All right. Nice. Next up. Mr. Silver Age, Dust Mites.
Hey, what's up, guys? If you didn't want to listen to the ETR show tonight, Enter the Realm, I got this Brooklyn T-shirt, and I'm going to big hug this dude right here. We got stomping.
Holy fuck.
So tomorrow I'll be stomping all you motherfuckers because this shit is, the box is just ridiculoid. It's ridiculous. It's off the meat rack, you know?
I can't wait to see you fix it up.
So, I have not had a chance to fuck with that. But that's, other than the flu and me taking a dive off the back steps, that's my haul for the week.
All right, sweet. I look forward to those pictures. I like your showcase pictures that you put up on IG and stuff.
The haul or the flu or... dive off the back steps.
No, the, you know, the stomp, of course.
Stomped off the back steps.
Well, no doubt.
That's a big fucking box, though, man. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's fucking huge, man. Tommy, I cannot... Look at this fucking thing, man. It's a fucking... You know what I feel like? I feel like I'm fucking... what's his name? Fucking from Transformers. Fucking Spike Wickwicked you, whatever, the spark plug. Whatever.
Oh, when he was running around the city with it. Yeah. Sam, get to the building.
The cube! I gotta put it up to my chest. I got the cube right here, man. I got the cube or the scorn or the orb or whatever the fuck they called it.
Megatron fucking chasing him.
Yeah, whatever. It's in my hand right now, motherfucker.
All right, next up, Tommy Barricade. What's up, brother?
Oh shit! What did I get? I got a couple gifts actually. You know, I got a gift from Lance. He gave me one, so that was kind of cool. It's one of these super figure, whatever they call them. These were back in the day.
Reveltech?
Starscream. Yeah, it's kind of like that. Yeah,
it's a Reveltech.
They're pretty cool. So I got the Starscream. He gave that to me. So big ups.
Shout out to Lance, man.
Really? Yeah, Lance, man. I wasn't expecting that. He said he gave it to me because he said I had a pretty tough month in April, which I fucking did. You guys know that, man. Like, yep. Holy shit.
What's his name? Kindhold or Kinds?
Kindholds or something like that.
I don't know how to pronounce his name, man. Lance, I'm sorry if I'm butchering your name, man. But
just Lance.
Just send me a little message on my phone. And like, tell me your name. Kindhold.
And I got this Starkiller base Kylo that Jose helped me out get. That's fucking sweet. That's fucking great, man. Love it. Oh, sorry about the noise in the background. Got a bunch of fucking Harleys going around.
Oh,
here.
Rough Riders.
Yeah.
Winnipeg Rough Riders.
I don't doubt it. So we got another one of these fucking chameleons. I only got a second one because I wanted to use the body for Hammerhead or for fucking Jameson there, so I don't have to fucking, keep popping the head off. So I picked up another one of those. And then, fuck, I went and picked up five more of these fucking three-quarter inch. I can't hold them all up, but there's a whole bunch of them here, man. I got a bunch of them going on. Fucking another one here. Got a whole bunch of them all over the fucking place. What the fuck am I going to do with these things? I don't know. And I'm also expecting sometime this week I'll get another one of those big bitches, fuck. The big fucking TIE Fighters, so I'll have two of them. So I'll have those two, these five I picked up, and another two I picked before, so I'll have, nine fucking TIE Fighters in there.
Tommy. Sick collection. Tom. Yeah. We need some fucking talk time tomorrow, bro. We definitely need a little talk time, bro.
I love these TIE Fighters. I'm tying one on, you know what I'm saying?
Hey.
And then last but not least, but I got another little kind of aluminum fucking water bottle thing.
Aluminium.
Aluminium. I got this from my boy Dennis, Destron Logical. It's in the ROC. He gave me that, so that was pretty cool. And he got me another little tiny barricade, whatever, little toy. That's about it. That was my...
A little butt plug?
No, it wasn't a butt plug.
you see how quick he caught that?
I got a tattoo on my backside. It says exit only. Okay.
He was like, he caught it so quick. He's like, no, it's not a butt plug. Tom was like, that's a...
Fuckers.
All right. Next up, we got Kenny Prime. And Kenny Prime, real quick, shout out to you. You're wearing a Balor Club t-shirt. I see it. You rock. Sweet.
That's right.
What type of t-shirt? What? Lay back. Let's. What do you want? What do you want?
What is that?
Finn Balor t-shirt.
It's Finn Balor.
Who?
Okay.
It's the first wrestling item I've bought in like 20 years.
It's okay. Wrestling, Dust. It's wrestling.
Wrestling?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What's that?
Four Horsemen? Hip-hop album coming out soon? Okay, whatever.
What's up, Kenny, man? Tell us what you got. How you doing tonight?
Pretty good. I don't even know when I've gotten things lately, but I got my stickers from Magna Boss today, so I put them on. They were a bitch, and I didn't do a very good job. But he looks pretty good.
The
Masterbot concept.
Sticker set for what?
For Magna Boss. It was like
okay.
Yeah, they put them out at BotCon, the stickers. I didn't know that you could buy them at BotCon. I don't know if they sold out. There wasn't very many made. So I bought them on eBay and got some other, got like the figures, just ordered second versions of the figures and stickered them up to change them over to, Magnum Boss characters. So it's pretty good. I mean, it works for having, something opposite the box set, the Predacus, a combiner, so... I'm pretty happy with them.
Yeah, that's cool.
Sweet. All right, next up, Victory Saber 77. What's up, bro?
Hey, what's up, everyone?
Halls for me, you know, check out the ETR show.
He's got everything. That's right. He's got this, he's got that, he's got that. He's got that, that thing over there. He's got a little bit over here. He's got those things over there. And when you climb up and see the back thing over there, yeah, he's got that too.
So, best is so far I got the Black Panther.
Ooh.
And so I got two of those, which is nice.
Sorry for going off on that guy a little bit on your post about those Black Panthers.
I kind of read that this morning. I was like, what the hell's going on? it's all good, man.
Kenny, did you go all in?
No, it gets to me when people, like, you post, like, a photo of something, and someone's like, hey, can I buy that off you? And it's just like, well, no, you can't.
And what did you say? You know,
like, I told him he was aggressive.
Aggressive.
I said, damn, bro, that's aggressive.
That's aggressive, son.
Yeah, I don't like that either.
Yeah, and then
he
said something else, and I was like, dude, would you go into my house and, like, look at my shelves and start telling me everything you'd want to buy? Like, no, like, it's, you know, kind of something similar there, so.
I do that.
And he called me rude.
It's different if it was someone that I knew, maybe. Right. But I don't even think I even know the guy or he's even a follower and all that type of stuff, so it's like, you know.
Yeah.
No, thanks.
Out of here.
All right, next up, Nightwinging them. What's up, bro? Happening.
Not a whole lot.
ED, what's up?
I jumped off into a rabbit hole that Jisk is going to be severely disappointed with me in.
Uh-oh. Marvel.
You sold everything.
No.
I can't even see what that is. You bought a...
Beast Wars. Season 2 and 3. Which means I'll probably wind up getting the figures as well.
Well, you need something to put on the shelves behind you, bro.
Yes.
Well, those are all seasons for the Autobots. Obviously, I have no season 4.
I could tell by the sign, but, you know, cool, yeah. Man. Well, looks good.
We went there.
Nice.
I'm
fully working on it. Now, my Decepticon season 1 is almost done.
You're looking up at it. Is it in front of you?
Yeah.
It's holding.
Oh, so you have the Decepticons in front of you and the Autobots behind you.
Yeah, I'm not going to put the Decepticons at my back. That would imply growth.
Yeah, why would you? No, I'm totally with you. Why would you do that?
Yeah, I'm sitting here looking at Megatron, Starscream, Sunstorm, Acid Storm, and I'm waving his cape.
Okay.
Where'd you get the cape from?
Cape? I said capes.
Cape.
Oh, I thought you said cape. I thought you were talking about Starscream's cape. I'm like, dude, that's what I need.
TFC toys.
No, I want one of those.
The TFC toys sell? Is it the cloth one?
Yeah, they sold I think the crown and cloth set.
Yeah, no. The shoulder grab. I like the plastic. No,
you want the plastic joint.
Oh, well.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to fucking break down and buy that Starscream.
Oh God,
I paid a lot for mine, man. A year ago, I paid a lot of money.
I may do the same thing, Drisk, and if I do that, this Hasbro one is getting repainted.
Drisk?
Yeah, I thought said Drift. I'm like,
I thought he said Drisk.
Dude, I'm being stalked by this. There's a moth in here that's fucking stalking me.
Mothra! The Mothman!
Mothra!
Yep, and last but not least, Jisk 1, a.k.a. Jabotron, a.k.a. Mr. a.k.a. What's up, brother?
Man, what's going on? I got a moth problem, apparently.
He's a Mothra problem. He's Mothra.
I got Fans Toys Sludge, which is... or their Stomp is what they call it. It's fucking awesome.
Gone!
I got my second Masterpiece Ultra Magnus, and I forgot to mention this. I got my Toy World leg bots, and I had gotten them, but I never opened them. I just sent them straight to Bobby to review, so I finally got to mess with them, and they're pretty fucking sweet.
Yeah, I like them too.
Dust, I'm telling you, man, I think you'll like the set, man.
I know, I'm trying to hold out, man. I'm trying to hold out. I need to do it now before it gets harder. I need to do it now before it gets harder to do it, you know?
Listen, I will say that especially Scrapper specifically does feel like a Masterpiece version of the Combiner Wars. Like that's the feeling I get when I look at it.
But then when I saw Shovel's legs, they were really fucking... Oh.
Yeah, that's...
I'm good with them. I'm good with them. Yeah, I think he looks pretty good. Yeah, it's a little bit...
Oh, man, they're just like... It's just like...
I think the Scrapper, the Generation builds... The Generation toys, the Gravity Builder, their Scrapper, to me, is the best Scrapper. The head, I understand, is not right, but just everything about the body and everything.
Yeah, that's why they dropped it first. That's why they dropped it first.
Oh, yeah, the rest of them just...
Brilliant.
And I like the Mixmaster, too, but the arm bots are fucking terrible for that. They're not terrible. Excuse me. But the arm... Toy World just did a better job there. But you can now... I mean, you can see, like... I think Bobby pointed it out, and it does make a lot of sense, like, where... These really should be, like, $120 figures. The Toy World ones. But, like, they kind of cut some corners a little bit.
So, okay. So, the size and the mass... is that money. But
yeah,
there's certain things in that that's they're taking out.
Yeah, there's some things that are a little... They're not terrible. Honestly, they're not terrible. It's going to be interesting to see how that thing holds up. Because the legs don't have combiner ports like your traditional combiners do. So I don't know how those thighs are going to plug in.
Oh, it's going to be because it's that one piece is going to be... It's going to be a parts former.
But I don't even see how it hooks into the bots. Did you check that out, Jose? Did you see how that works?
He's back in.
You.
Jose, do you know how the those Toy World legs, like that I was just saying, they don't really have combiner ports on them. Do you know how those things are going to connect together?
Yeah, when Burden comes out, I think with him, it's parts forming. There's going to be pieces that attach to the top parts of Scrapper and Mixmaster's legs.
Where on Scrapper do they plug in? That's my question.
On the feet. Like, basically, like, where the feet are, when it's in alt mode, it's going to plug, like, right on top. Somehow. It's going to be something that I think it goes, like, right over.
I don't know why, and it's not really a concern for me because I'm not keeping them in combined mode, but I have a feeling this is combiner is not going to be that sturdy.
I felt like with the arms, like those joints were tight. So I think it is gonna, be solid.
It's the legs, though, really, is what I'm concerned with.
Yeah,
I'm concerned with the fact that it looks like Urkel.
It looks like Urkel, Steve Urkel.
Yeah, when we're standing there.
The pelvic thrust.
Yeah.
Steve Urkel.
Oh.
Yeah, no, but you don't have to have it like that. Like, I've seen pictures where it's just, like, he's straight up. Like, you could, I guess that's supposed to, I don't know if that's supposed to be, like, an ab crunch or what, but.
Remember the picture of War of Atron Bruticus when they showed, how far back it went, how far back it bent without falling?
Dude, War of Atron Bruticus really is dope. Like, you look at, I have three combiners right now. I've got Bruticus, I've got Computron, I've got Feral Rex, and that Bruticus just looks so, like, it's the best looking one out of the three. It looks fucking awesome.
Just don't tilt the foot.
My ankle tilts are fine on mine. Like, I haven't had any issues.
I heard people, they snap theirs and stuff.
I snapped mine. No. Let's take what he said.
I did not snap mine.
You heard. What the fuck? If you don't, you heard. Don't worry about what you hear. Don't worry about what you heard.
You're talking about the ratchets, right, Matt?
Oh, man. Those
I heard.
Are you talking about, like, the tilt? Like, when you tilt them to the get an ankle tilt?
You know what? I heard your door is going to fall off. That's what I heard.
Got the wind.
I installed them when it was windy as fuck yesterday.
Yeah, well, you know what? Yeah. Windy as fuck right now. You heard.
But Matt, just to talk about that.
The foot tilt.
Yeah, I snapped the foot ratchets and then bought these aftermarket ones that were way too strong.
Aftermarket?
I snapped the foot ratchets, shoved it up his ass, and I bought these new ones. That's what he's saying right now.
Well, mine are fine, but, I haven't really manipulated him too much, like, since I put them together.
Yeah.
Took a few pics, put them on the shelf, and I haven't really moved them since, so...
I have nowhere to put this other Ultra Magnus, I realize.
Up your ass.
I got it today, and I'm like, shit, man.
Up your ass, Magnus.
He's not all code is long.
He's not infinite.
Just leave it in the box and wait for it.
So, wait, Jess, you really have two of everything so far?
No, I want to. I don't have two of everything. I barely... I don't have two of a lot of things. Like, I have more things that are singular.
Right.
I'm getting there.
Huh. That's the goal.
Well, like, the things that are going to be tough, like Soundwave, like, if I find somebody that's just selling the robot for, like, cheap, I'll pick that up. Man, you know, Swage was a while, like, 3 months ago, and I should have fucking jammed on it.
Yeah.
He had one just Soundwave and, like, his guns and stuff for $100, and I was like...
Wow, you should have just fucking jumped on that one, wow.
But they'll come back around. I mean, that's honestly, like, that's what I'm looking for at TFCon, is cheapy doubles.
You probably
that's the best place to get it.
You know what I mean?
Because then I'm not going
to Bad paint, limp wrist, I got it. I'll buy it. You know?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, if they'll give me a better deal, because I don't mind fixing stuff, man. I bought a pin punch the other day.
What do you need it for, cassette mode or robot mode?
Well, I would need it for A mode.
Oh, duh, that's
right. Yeah, I already have one in robot mode, so I'd probably need one for cassette mode.
I was just thinking, if the arm broke or something, then that one would be the cassette mode. That's, never mind. Right over.
Yeah, no, I hear you.
Whatever one looks best in what mode, right?
I think... You know, I need to get Transistor again, so I'm probably just going to get the regular, like the non-Metallica one is what I'd like to get for the second one.
Now, Jess, did you get a Sound Blaster?
What do you mean a Sound Blaster?
Right.
I thought about it, and I decided not to go that route.
That one was really good, though. I don't have an attachment to that character, but it was good.
Just because I have no attachment to that character, and then every time I see it, it'll just look a little less than. It just won't look right to me.
Now you got the two of them.
Like, so, for example, like I have a blue sore, and then I picked up the red sore, and like now, like, which is fine, but I wish like I would have had the blue one. I wish I had two blues instead of one red, one blue.
Mm. Yeah, they have.
So you like the blue one better than the red one?
Just because it's cartoon accurate. Both are awesome. Like sore, that figure is awesome, and the red just kind of. But like, so what I've been doing too is I've been buying repro labels, and then I've been putting them just all on one figure. So like on all the bad cube bugs. Look what I almost said. On all the fans. On all the fans toys bugs, like those.
Look at him smiling, man. Look at him smiling right now.
Those
all. Fuck you, just.
You gave him a chubby.
You got him smiling.
Yeah, so I think that's what we'll do with the repro labels is the alt modes will be the ones that have all the labels on them.
Yeah.
So it's cool. It's getting there.
Nice.
I was just
asking if you like the blue one or more of the red one because I think my next project after a couple more MPs, I'm going to do some Dinobots.
Blue one, you're going to have a hard time finding the sore. Maybe not sore, but definitely Scoria.
Scoria.
Yeah, Scoria is impossible to find.
Unless you don't care... Sorry,
about
hold on.
Paying the inflated price.
Well, no, unless you don't care that the color's a little off. Like, cause even my Scoria, the second one, is like the
metallic one,
the toy version, I guess. Yeah, it actually looks really nice. It's like the one that's like the transistor paint, and it looks really good. That's the one that's in bot mode, and it looks awesome.
Yeah,
but like those.
I like the metallic ones that they put out.
Yeah. My Sever's not; they're both the same. But like, and I don't buy doubles of those. Like, I'll wait until somebody's selling a stomp. Like, that's how I got those. My second set of Dinobots was just I got all three of them from one person, and it was just too good of a deal to pass up.
Nice.
So, I think Stomp is the first one I've paid full retail for. Well, it's not really full retail. It's from Handy, so you get it discounted. But you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I didn't get it for like $100 or like $100.
Agabus.com.
I was about to say, shout out to Agabus.com.
Yeah, man, he's shipping those things quick.
Yeah,
that dude today was just like, Forager came in. I was like, all right, I'll grab it at some point. He's like, I shipped it to you.
Yeah, he's like,
I shipped it to you.
Well, I guess I gotta pay you, buddy.
I'm just happy that they like give me little notes when I buy stuff. They're like, "Oh, thanks for your continued thing," and I was like, "Oh, cool."
I don't get those.
I've never seen one of those fucking notes ever.
I want some love notes.
We're regular customers. We reach out to them cool. on Facebook, so we don't need it.
Fuck you, Dust. I'm hooking you up enough. You ain't
getting you ain't getting no special letter. Fuck.
Well, let me ask you, Kenny, did you order from the website?
Yeah, I've ordered three.
Who the fuck orders? Hit him up on Facebook, man. Don't fucking go through the website.
Why?
Because you don't use
Facebook. You're the only one that's doing it.
You're paying more money, man. Fuck that website shit, man. Just hit him up on Facebook, man.
Yeah, man.
Don't be that good. Hey, what's up, Hanny? I'm Kenny Prime from ROC. This is what I want. Okay.
this is what I want.
Magically, it's 10% less. Oh, wow. How'd that happen?
Yeah, and he'll chat you up to make sure like you got everything settled.
R.O.C.
Yep.
Yeah.
Ring.
Yeah, don't worry, man. He'll take the time to talk to you there, Kenny.
Yeah, right, shout out to Hanny, man. Shout out to Hanny. He hooks it up, and he's same day shipping.
You know what? You go through the website, man. You just like a normal Joe, man. Just do the ROC joint. Just
I am a normal Joe. I don't need special
treatment. Get the fuck out of here, Kenny.
Also, I'm just gonna put this out there: the more people that hit him up through Facebook, that means the longer it's gonna take to get back to your replies, Tommy and Dust.
I have no problem with my replies, man.
No, I got my replies pretty quick. Yeah. I got mine in, 30 seconds after Jose got his? That's there you go.
Yeah,
quick, done.
I never stress about that stuff. Like, the dude's cool. Like He's I said, cool, he's cool. It's definitely his cheaper.
His packaging is amazing. Like,
his packaging is on point. He's definitely cheaper than BBTS and TF
Swords. It's too on point, man. I almost
hurt
myself.
Same day shipping.
Stop out of the box, man.
He stole it right out of the factory. Like,
what?
He stole it right out of the factory.
He's done a lot of solids for me on figures that I didn't even buy from him, so that dude has my business.
Yeah, I can't wait to TF Con, man. This dude's going to have the whole fucking suite. I think he's got the penthouse going on. We're going to have a party up there.
He better get ready to wheel and deal. I'm going to come in there.
Look, wheel and deal.
Oh, look at Deluxe Baldwin. Oh,
look
Jesus
at that fear.
Fucking Christ, man. This guy got to pop in.
Hail Hydra.
We won't let anybody in here, won't we?
What?
I didn't catch that.
I said, we'll just let anybody in here, won't we?
Yeah, well, he keeps scratching his nose. You know what that means?
Somebody
talking about him.
A little
white under there, fuck.
Cocaine.
Deluxe, did you see Civil War yet?
Alright, I gotta turn my TV down, sorry.
No, you definitely gotta tell you.
Shut up. Don't take it to
me. Shut up. He said, like, shut up. Fuck you, bro.
Take a nap. How y'all doing? Y'all doing alright?
Chillin'.
I was watching a little bit, talking about Agabus and stuff and everything. Whatever. Yep.
Have you ordered from them yet?
I think about ordering a Kickback. I was going to go through the site because I ain't got it good like y'all. I got to be like Kenny.
No, dude, that's you right. Can hit him up. I told him you maybe. I told average him Joe's. Him up. Average Joe's.
My phone's fixing to die. Fuck.
What if they were called? What if it was called GI Jim and they were like, "Yo, Jim."
AverageJoes.com.
Go sell my car. Look at my car, guys. Everybody, look at my car.
I'm looking at it.
I don't know. That's what mess sounds like. Fuck, my phone's done.
Good night, folks. All right.
Oh, Jose, what about some of these topics that we were talking about?
We got some topics tonight? We got topics?
We got a few. Yes, sir.
Well, it was concerning like the Hasbro stuff with the all the reveals that we had on Do You Even Transform, Bro? Hasbro got a bunch of stuff coming out in the coming year, so just wanted to get everybody's thoughts on their upcoming line. And then as a follow-up to that, if you're going to be collecting it, which piece are you looking forward to the most out of what's coming out? So, anybody want to go first?
Deluxe popped in just in time, like he knew that was going to be the question.
Yeah, but did they talk at Hasbro Transformers? I'm in there. Yeah, well, he's not in here right now, so
can't hear him yet.
Yeah, I'm not probably not going to buy any of that stuff, so I can't.
I'm buying every single one.
Oh, Kenny's Kenny's waving the flag. Kenny. Come on, Kenny. Talk
so
to
us. So what's
up?
Let us know. Yep. Let us know. What are your thoughts on the line? Because they revealed a lot of stuff, so, you know.
Oh, I think it's going to be a nice, like, refreshing, you know, difference from the Combiner. So I love the Combiner Wars line, but I think they all look really good. Seeing them all in person, like, I don't know if there's one I'm excited about most or anything. I mean, Fort Max looks great. I think Highbrow looks really cool, and I have no attachment to that character at all, but I think he looks awesome. But so those two pop up to mind. But I think they all look really, really good, and it's just gonna, you know, I don't know. I'm really excited about it. So
that's cool. What about the stuff that leaked out like recently, like the with the Megatron and the Six Shot?
Oh yeah. Crap, there was one of those that I really liked, but I can't remember off the top of my head what it was.
They had quite a few characters. They had what was it, Hunger, right? Double the Terracons.
Hunger, they had the new Megatron, new Optimus. Double Cross, yeah.
There's Double Cross.
I forget what else was there.
Mind Wipe.
Oh, yeah, the Hot Rod.
Mind Wipe we knew. Yeah, Hot Rod was new. It wasn't. Was it Downshift? Was the car or Spur?
I think it was
Getaway.
Balls
in your mouth. It was Getaway.
There was
Getaway.
It wasn't
Getaway.
Balls in your mouth.
No, it was not Balls in your mouth. It was not Butt Plug.
Just checking.
I think they look really good. I think, you know, even like the remolds, like the Blur and the Chrome Dome, I think, are like remolds of each other. I think they look different enough, you know what I mean? I know a lot of people hate on them for, you know, repaints and stuff, but I don't know. I think they all look really, really solid, so.
Right. So when you go in on these lines, do you collect every single figure or just the ones that appeal to you?
I collect the ones that appeal to me, which is usually every single figure. it just kind of happens that way. But yeah, like I said, like when I saw them in person at BotCon, like there wasn't anything like, and they have like the little headmasters like they sell on their own, with, like a little vehicle or something, which I don't know much about. But like even those things look pretty cool. So I don't know. I'm excited for them to come out.
Yeah.
That might be Astro one of those Train cases like
Astro Train.
Yeah.
Mm. You have the space for all that stuff, Kenny?
I'm sorry, say again. I cut out.
There. You have all the space? You have the space for that?
I make the space. I make it happen. I can get more shelves. I can rearrange my house.
Yeah, that's the key thing. You gotta make it happen.
I don't have the space for the big guys. Like, I'm upset that Metroplex is like on the ground, you know. But I'd like to get maybe like a table or something so I can have the big guys like kind of hang out.
Yeah, Ford Max is definitely one of the things I'd like to pick up for sure. But I've learned my lesson from the Combiner Wars. I'm not collecting all the fucking Titan Wars. Fuck that shit. I'm finishing off this Combiner Wars. That's it, man. If there's anything from the Titan Wars, it'll be kind of like one of those impulse buys. If it's in the store and I kind of like that character, then, you know, maybe I'd pick it up. But I'm kind of more focused on the Masterpiece. But it is refreshing to see something new come out. That's for sure.
I can see a lot of us picking up Fort Max, like, out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's when I grew up.
Well,
I never had a Fort Max, so that's why I want to get it, right? I never had it. So.
Yeah, I had the original. Mm-hmm. That was like a nice piece. You know, I kind of want to get the reissue of that just because of, like, the childhood memories.
Memories.
But, like, the Fort Max, it, like, I picked up the Metroplex and really, like, had no use for it. But it did, you know, I was able to sell it for more than I paid for it. And it basically paid for my Masterpiece Ultra Magnus. So I don't know if I'm, like, you know, maybe I should pick up Fort Max and hold on to it for, like, a year and a half, 2 years, maybe resell it.
That Metroplex is up for, like, $400 or $500.
How much?
Like, $400 or $500.
That much?
I only ever saw one Metroplex in store, and I bought it, and I never saw another one.
I didn't see them in any of my stores, not even at the Costco's like they said they would. Nothing, like, ever hits around here, so sucks for me.
You talking about Generation Metroplex?
Yeah,
the 2 foot one.
500? Did he say 500?
Mm-hmm.
No.
I've seen it for like 250, like on eBay and stuff like that. Like, yeah, higher.
150 easy. 150 is.
I'll see if
that's it. Not the dust. I sold mine for 210.
Shut up. I'm gonna fucking scrape the dust off mine, man. It's in the
210 ship.
It's in the official dust mine's fucking hallway, man. I gotta take a picture and be like, oh, I gotta scrape the dust off, man.
See, Deluxe is back in. Deluxe, we were bringing up Hasbro and like all their slate of upcoming products that's coming out. Mm. So we were asking like, what are your thoughts on what they have, and if you're gonna be getting it, like, what's your most one you're looking forward to the most out of what's coming
up? Am I getting it?
My balls.
That's all I'm getting.
Balls?
I don't know. I'm gonna what to call.
What's that? You cut out a little bit.
And then he skips.
Oh, he's frozen.
Yeah.
Can't hear him. I'll try him again when he comes back.
Well, Tommy, were you going to be looking at anything else in that line, or just the Fort Max?
I like that. Was it Vector Sigma? Is it Alpha Trion? I don't mind that.
Alpha Trion, yeah.
The Alpha Trion, yeah. I don't mind that mold. See, the thing is, I have to see it in hand, right? Like, I'm seeing those pictures, but seeing it in hand is different, right? When you're in the store and you pick it off the fucking shelf, right? So
yeah,
it's one of it's gonna be an impulse to buy because I'm not, you know, like, I'm collecting every Combiner Wars one, but you know, I'm not gonna do that again, man. Fuck that shit. You know, it's I'm not gonna do that again. It's crazy. It's gonna be a Masterpiece mostly, but like I said, it'll be an impulse buy with these Titan Wars, but definitely that Fort Max. That's gonna be one of them.
Anybody else going in on those lines?
I will not be.
I'll get Fort Max, and then maybe the Headmaster and Target Masters.
You won't find Fort Max, you just said.
Yeah, I know. I'll have to get it on online for scalp price.
Well, you can get it at BBTS or one of those.
Don't say TF source.
As soon as I do that, it'll be sold out. That's always my luck.
Send you something different.
Pre-order. That's what the pre-order.
What happened to me with Masterpiece Soundwave? I had it in my cart. I went to check out, and I was like, oh, can't have it. I'm like, what the?
That's Toys R Us, man. You can't do that, people.
Ugh.
Website sucks.
I kind of like the Galvatron that's coming out. That looks pretty good. But I don't know how it scales.
With what?
It's a leader class, though, no?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, what are you trying to say?
No, it was like a Voyager size.
That's what.
It's going to be Voyager, the yeah. Galvatron?
That's okay.
I kind of like the way that looked in pictures, though. Thought it did look interesting, but it's just, I don't know, just like it's kind of like what everybody else is doing, like just kind of just focusing the collection towards the Masterpiece line. So it's like I don't want to get back into all that Chug stuff now.
Yeah.
The only reason
if you never left like me, stop. you'd be fine.
No, I mean I was all in. I bought all the Combiner War stuff, and I bought like a lot of the Generation stuff. But it's just I kind of see like now it's like like I don't like need it. Like I don't have the display it. I don't have the space for it. You know, like, I'd rather get, like, the Masterpiece, you know, the Masterpieces where I could just have a little shelf and throw them up and,
you know. The only reason I'm thinking about going for the for the city bots, like Metroplex and Fort Max, going with the Titans, is they're not going to scale with anything anyhow. And they're close enough.
Oh, he's back.
Sorry. I don't have bad weather here, so. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah,
we can hear you.
Shoot.
Yeah, I hear you.
I heard your question. Is anybody else talking? I'm sorry if they are. I don't want to over-talk anybody.
Yeah, that Nightwiggin was just finishing what he was saying about getting the city bots.
Okay.
The city bots, like I said, it doesn't matter what scale they are, they're not going to fit with anything. Metroplex, you'd need one that the size of a city block for it to scale properly.
Yeah. I mean, they try to make the Legends fit. You know what I'm saying? And I guess that's the best that they could do as far as that goes, you know?
Do you think that's why they're downscaling everything? Like, the Headmasters are, like, small, like, deluxe size.
Saving that money.
Yeah, exactly. Less material, less money.
That's true.
Yeah. Why do you think they're so...
They're just kind of smaller in general, right? Like, I know the deluxes now are smaller than the deluxes that were out, like...
Yeah, they're down.
Like, what, 8 years ago? 6 years ago?
Deluxe, are you getting smaller?
I think they started that with Transformers Prime. Because the Voyager size looks like deluxes.
Well, I mean, that's just, you know, that's just the world we live in. I mean, you know, that's, it sucks, but, you know, that's the way Hasbro's going. You know, they don't care about, I mean, they care about the fans, but they don't. You know, that's why they're
Everybody in here see Civil War?
They're back from the fall of Cybertron stuff. That stuff was, like, the low point, I think.
Yeah, those deluxes were small. Like, and I liked them. Like, I liked the Optimus Prime that they did. That's the War for Cybertron one, though, not the...
Yeah, the War for Cybertron had, like, a million moving parts. The Fall of Cybertron was still good, but he was tiny, and that was, like, the best, you know, other than the Starscream mold, that was, like, the best one from the second game. But, like... You look at, like, the Jazz. I was talking about this the other day, I think, on Plastic Fanatics, but, like, you look at some of those other figures there, and there's just so much missing, and you're just like, all right. But, like, they rebounded from that, too. Like, they're better than that, you know what I mean? It's always going to change, you know, there's always going to be ups and downs, but yeah. I don't think, you know, I think they're putting out a pretty good thing. You know, if that's your scale, if you don't like that size or whatnot, you go Masterpiece. Of course, Masterpiece or World's different. But they're putting out some good stuff, I think, so.
Yeah, well, I like a lot of the stuff that we saw that's going to be coming out. Like, I don't think I'm going to be buying it, but it is refreshing to see, like, just after all the endless repaints and slight, totally. Like, remolds and stuff like that, you know? So,
my we'll question see. Is how long before you get the repaints
and remolds? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, we'll see in a year, like, when they start... You know, yeah, when two and three come out, it's probably going to be all the same shit.
We've already seen happen. The Getaway is a repaint of Chrome Dome.
Yeah, it's already starting.
Mm-hmm. Armada Demolisher, I think, maybe. If it's
Combine Wars, it was just, like, so much. Like, so just hopefully with this next line, we won't see
as much. I think it was 26 molds I think Combine Wars was 26 molds, I want to say, with 88 repaints.
Sorry, you got Masterpiece coming.
Not that many.
You guys want to see a picture of some repaints? Check this out. See if you can get that. If you can get that. Look at all those Bumblebees. Can you see it or no?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Look at that, man.
Those are all official releases, too?
Yeah.
It's the RID.
Isn't that crazy? That shit's crazy.
They literally moved the stripe from one side of the shoulder to the other and called it like a new figure. They
call it a new something, yeah. Fucking night this, night ops.
Yo, Tommy. Fucking
suck my nut, Bumblebee, whatever. What?
I was going to say, it looks like Dust is falling out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's end the live because he's the only one that can do it, so before he's too deep into it.
All right.
First of that, now the fun begins. Let's see if we can work it out. Yo, Dust. Dust.
Dust.
Dust Mike.
Damn, how are you going to fall out?
He's out, man. Oh, no, man.
Come on, we have a fundamental problem, folks.
Yo, Nightwiggin, just keep speaking. He'll wake up.
He'll wake up.
Does anybody have his telephone number? Just call him.
Oh yeah,
maybe
See, maybe the phone will wake him up.
Yeah, right.
It may, if you know what I mean.
Alright, well, yeah, as long as you got a ringer on.
Let's see.
I'll buzz him.
Oh, man, Dusty. Fucking Dust.
That's funny.
I mean, it happens. It happens, but...
It's all good.
Yeah.
I don't like to heal him, though. So, I don't have anybody else.
So, yeah, I want to go back to the Dinobots, since I'm planning on trying to get them all. That's going to be an expensive trek. That's for sure.
Dude, there's always people on them. That's what, you've been patient this far, I would just wait until you see them come up. Because, like, you'll see a lot of times people let those things go for, like, 120, dude. And then you can scoop them up, sometimes 130.
Hangouts keeps...
Yeah, I gotta sell to survive sometimes.
Tommy, just do what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get rammed.
He probably has this thing on silent, because I just bust him. And he's not budging.
And then I'm going to go in, get into the Fans Toys Dinos, their Insecticons, and the Toy World Constructicons.
Dude, honestly, like, out of all the three, just for money wise, your best bet is to get the Insecticons first.
That cube.
Yeah. No. I'm thinking I'm going to hit the Dinobots because I can get three of them relatively quickly, then get their Grimlock, and then keep an eye open for Scoria.
You may just have to
sell Hanny's got
Scoria, man.
Yeah, Hanny's got like three of them right now.
Yeah, but not. What, he's looking for the first.
Yeah, I'm hoping they will re-release it. I'm looking for the FT, not the FT, whatever.
You're gonna be paying like $300 for that thing.
We'll see what Evil Bay has.
Not if they do what they've done with Scoria, and not Scoria, but Swoop, and re-release it.
Well, they're supposed to be re-releasing it. Yeah, they're supposed to be re-releasing it under that new company or whatever.
No, Swoop, they're re-releasing. Period.
Yeah, I knew that. But I thought they said they weren't going to re-release the original because they released all the rest of them. They might release the toy version again, but not the original.
Toy had a part and from the horns.
They should just re-release it. If they know there's a market for it and like not everybody was able to get in on that first run, like just re-release it.
Weren't they just selling the heads? By themselves for a while?
No.
That was just the chrome, or the smoke.
Oh, because I have the smoke one. When I bought my other one, the guy had it. He's like, oh, I'll just throw it in.
They actually might do that, because, I mean, they did it with Quigwave, and, like, Quigwave is selling for, like, $500.
Dude, but look at how long it took. They're not going to, trust me, they're not
going to. That took years. Time.
Once Grimlock's out, maybe.
Yeah, that's what I was just going to say. They won't release it till at least Grimlock's out.
This is weird how, like, that one is, like, the gem. Like, out of all of them, I just don't know. Like, I think maybe Sword was, because Sword
was it? Cool. You gotta think when it came out almost 2 years ago. It was probably at a time when they were still a younger company. They didn't have a ton of dough, you know what I mean? So it's like,
runs
were more limited back then.
Yeah.
Which is another reason why they had to re-release it.
That was the first Dinobot, wasn't it? Besides, Grimlock, but that's not Fans Toys, so.
That was the first of the Fans Toys, yeah.
Right.
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay, that makes more sense.
Yeah, but...
Nope.
Yeah, I mean, deluxe.
Whichever Dinobot set you go, you're looking at like 1,000 at the least for retail.
More than that, because if you gotta count the shipping and stuff, you know, it's gonna be definitely more than that. $1,000.
Or that's more if you have two. That'd be
God damn. But there's such pretty versions that it's hard not to want them.
I kind of like the GK Creations or whatever it is, the one that's combiner. That one's actually not that bad.
Yeah.
And it scales well with Fans Toys Dinobots too.
But those are chug. Those are like chug size though.
No.
They're pretty decent. But yeah.
Those are chugs.
They're just a tad bit smaller than the MP.
I'll tell you this too, just about those. I have, you know, doubles of Soar, Scoria, and Sever, and then one Sludge, and I may just be out of G now. So you can find them, man. You can find them for real cheap. You just gotta jump on them. As soon as you see someone post it in the cafe or something, you have to fucking pounce on that shit.
You do, but we're all Transformer collectors, and then third party. You already know you're in it. Yeah. As far as money was. Well,
yeah, that's the problem. Like today, I almost picked up that stomp, and I was like, "Holy shit! Thank God I didn't." Because I'd be fucked, man. Because you know what, I have to get the rest of them, right?
That's why I work so much overtime. It's just to buy all the stuff that I want.
And I feel like if you got stomped first, you'd be bummed out about the other ones. It's that damn good.
Yeah, because it'd be like a letdown, right?
Yeah, and I don't have the other one, so it's like I just kind of I'm holding off for now on the
Deluxe. Dinobots. You collect the Fan Toys Dinobots Deluxe?
Yes, sir.
Did you get your stomp yet?
No, I gotta wait on him. I'm kind of broke right now.
Oh, I hear you, dude.
Yeah, so it's I'll good, wait for man. Him. He'll be around.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, yeah. I got the first runs and I got the red swoop because I just like the red. I may pick up the blue one later, but the red one's good.
The red one's cool. I like the blue one, but I was telling them earlier that the red one's still nice looking.
Yeah, I don't know why I went with the red one. I like the red one better than the blue one at that point. But, yeah, they're really good. Stomp looks really good. I watch y'all's little finger banging. And, you know, you always need a good sledge. I mean, sledge don't get any love at all. So.
Especially with googly eyes.
Dude, those will never see the light of day for me, dude.
No.
Never.
It's a great homage, homage or whatever, but, you know, nobody's really going to leave them on there, I don't think, you know.
For
but
2 seconds.
Yeah, it makes me think about all the different add-ons that...
They could at least came with, like a fire flame effect or something, like Figure Arts does. That would look cool.
I think isn't there another aftermarket company that does it? I call it aftermarket because it's not really third party.
Gigapower does that. Well, they do like the flame footsteps.
Yeah, but there is a company that just makes the effects like that. I saw him at BotCon at the Chosen Prime booth. They had him for Shockwave, and he had like all kinds of like electricity stuff around him. It was pretty cool. But I don't know the company name. Yeah.
Just was saying, you know, if you want to start with the Fan Toy stuff, I would highly, highly recommend Insecticons before the Dinobots, especially because they're a good price. Yeah. I mean, you can get them all three for $250?
They're $80 each, so what's 8 times? $240 for all three of them.
And
I'm at their. I'd be doing in the following month get another one.
I mean, Bombshell alone is probably maybe figure of the year last year. He's got to be at least top three. I know that.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
So, I know you want the Dinobots, but if you got the cash right then, I would highly, highly recommend the Fan Toys.
He's a beaut, man. Check that out. He's a beaut. Yeah. I love it.
And you got two choices of Bombshell. You can get him too. So that's another. Right. But you don't have to have that.
If you're traveling on Bombshell, it'd be the first try grab, and then come back and get Kickback.
Dude, don't underestimate Kickback, dude. It's an awesome figure.
Oh, I'm not. The only reason I would do it that way is those were the first two released, so the quantity number is lower on them.
Right, sure, I gotcha.
That's what's available.
But I don't count out Takara maybe doing them too. I mean, I know they got, you know, Inferno, I think Hound, Jetfire I heard was one, and they got, I think Jazz got scrapped because of the licensing, but I think they're going to put them out. You know, Cliffjumper will be right next to them. So yeah, right. I think Takara may, I mean, they've shown love to the Insecticons. I can see them doing an MP style. I don't know if you could do anything different. You know, they're kind of like the Dinobots. You really can't make them better, but they'll be official, you know, products. You know, that's the reason why most people will buy them.
I don't have a problem having duplicates of the Insecticons and official on
another. Oh, yeah, that, yeah.
Because they clone. You know, I've even thought, and this is going to make Matt very happy here, I have even thought about getting the Bad Cube one.
Are you getting naked? No.
Dude, I thought about that too. Ed, I thought about that too until I got the Fan Toys in my hand, and then I knew there was no going back.
Well, they'd be there just solely for the clone purpose and be Captain.
Yeah, if you do it for the Swarm, it'd be perfect. I mean, that'd be good to do that.
That would be the sole reason.
That's why I'm thinking Takara, a little further down the line, they may do an Insecticons. Insecticons themselves. You know, most people just get them because, hey, they could build, you know, a Swarm, you know, so.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, and
some people just like offense. You know, that's some people do that. You know, whatever.
Some people army build.
I'll grab one of each of the third-party Scourge, and then whenever the official comes out, that will be Scourge, and the rest will be the Swarm. Will be the Sweeps.
Dude, what about that MP Inferno?
Mm.
Looking forward to it.
See my nipple? It's kind of hard.
I haven't said this about a masterpiece, like an official MP in a while, but that thing looks so good.
That head sculpt is fucking...
Dude, that puppy ass, and I'm a happy camper.
I don't think the head sculpt could get any better, man. That would just... Damn.
I don't think the third-party stuff looks weak for it, but I think they're like, the weakest...
No, they're like, that's the good ones.
My only
I think they look good, but I think compared to, like, some of the other stuff that has come out, I think they're, like, among, like, the weaker third-party figures, so I think that kind of makes the official one look a little bit better, too.
It's possible.
My only major question is, where is the ladder?
It folds up into the back.
Mm-hmm.
If there's a photo floating around, it's of the, it's kind of like at a backward angle, and you can see the back of it, and you can see that it folds up and kind of fits into the back, into the cab. At least that's what it looks like, or it's not on there yet.
This might be one of the older designers that did this. This might be one of like a newer designer, not the one that's been doing them lately, like Ironhide and Ratchet and all that.
How are you gonna feel if you get that thing and it's made out of the same materials like Shockwave's made out of? Like, not it just kind of thinner plastic.
I didn't think that Shockwave had bad materials.
Oh, I just felt like this the plastic
quality. Very light,
thinner.
Yeah, it was light. I mean, I don't see if you're just looking at Inferno, he looks beefy. So I don't know if he's gonna be. I think he's gonna be a little hefty. I think he'll have to be. I mean, he's a fire truck.
You say that.
Yeah. Oh, no, there's a possibility. I mean, yeah, it could be light as, you know, a fucking, you know, feather or something. I don't know. But I have good hopes. I always have good hopes on MP. I mean, I have not been disappointed with NMPs at all. So, and that's just me. I love the Masterpiece Collection. That's the reason why a lot of people collect. It's because of that Masterpiece. So.
Oh, that's all I collect.
So, I don't know. It looks good. I hope I think Hound's going to look good. I've heard Willie. I love my... Hey, there's Dust Mice. I love my MMC Hound. I probably will pick up the MP1 just because it's Masterpiece. But I've heard that Willie looks... I watched Bobby's review, and it looks pretty tight, too.
It's good, man.
It's probably broke just mirrors.
No, it was Ace that broke him.
MMC made a Hound, too?
It's going to be an interesting figure banging this Wednesday. Yeah.
It was breaking anyway, but...
I'm sorry, which one made Hound? It wasn't MMC, was it?
No, Make Toys. Yes. Make Toys.
I'm sorry, not MMC, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. I thought that was another Make one. Toys. I was like, did I miss something?
Ah, they're all the same shit, who cares?
You're talking about Gundog is Make Toys.
Yeah.
Fuck, Gundog is awesome, I love him.
It's a good figure.
That's the one I got. I Willie better.
Yeah, no, it's awesome. And that's where, like, I don't even know if I have the time to be on figure banging this week, but it's like I almost feel like I have to because Ace is just going to shit on that thing. And it's good. Like, it's really good. Don't listen to that guy. I'm giving you
Ace not shit on Willie?
it'll be interesting to hear the counterpoint, you know?
He hates that thing bad with a passion.
Already, huh?
Yeah.
He doesn't like it at all.
Oh, well.
So that's cool.
He's expressed himself quite well in the kick chat.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I thought he would actually like change his mind once he had like the figure in hand. Like he figured like maybe in pictures he's not feeling it, but once he has it in hand, he'll like it. But you know,
that not. Dude doesn't like it. I don't think that dude likes like you know things that are overly complicated, and that the transformation can be man it, like it can eat you up if. You've got to be real specific.
Bobby, did you get a chance job. To? You got a chance to mess with it before you?
Yeah. I sent the photos too. I don't know if it's when I first got it. I messed with it.
Yeah.
And so I transformed.
Oh yeah, that's
it.
Right. That's right. Yeah.
And it but does.
To be
it'll.
Fair, you guys don't have the instructions either. So yeah, the transformation is going to eat you up. You just got to figure it out.
Yeah, but those instructions ain't worth shit either. I mean, fuck that.
Yeah, man, some instructions are fucking garbage.
I have to watch people. I like to watch. I can't just read the instructions and transform. I have to watch somebody do it. I don't
like to open those bags. I'm like real like particular about not opening the bags. So if I can figure it out on my own, or if I can, I'll watch somebody.
I mean, I like a good transformation, but if it's just too damn hard, I'll do it once and I'm done. You know,
that's one of the reasons that's why I got Gundog. I loved like the arm transformation. I just thought that was so cool and different.
Yeah, that is cool the way that accordion's out.
Oh, I'm actually selling something for the first time.
Oh, what are you selling?
I have the masterpiece, the Hasbro Thundercracker and Skywarp.
Ooh, what's up with that Skywarp, son?
I'm gonna sell them as a pair. Do you want both of them?
I know someone that wants it.
I don't need the Thundercracker.
Somebody's
messaging him right now.
Okay.
Well, I have Thundercracker on its way. I'm waiting for Skywarp, and I want the 11 mold, not the 3.
Yeah, I have the Takara mode, so I just don't need them. And somebody's offering Utopia for a good deal for me, so I'm gonna try to sell those. I was gonna try to do
a cry over here.
You're gonna cry? What?
Yes, because I do want that Skywarp.
I want to try and sell them as a pair. I was gonna do 250 shipped. So I think that's
yeah, that's not bad for both of them.
No. Look, but I can't do anything until next month either. Until the first.
I don't hold stuff for you, Knight. So.
For some reason, it doesn't happen, Deluxe. I'm interested in that Skywarp.
Really? Well, I thought you had Skywarp.
I don't. That's the only. I don't have one, and I can't. I'm not gonna spend. I didn't want to spend $200 for the MP11, and I'm not trying to spend $300 or whatever it is now.
Yeah. How much is that Thundercracker still? $500.
I found it for $167.
Damn.
I have the Hasbro, you know, whenever Hasbro released the MP11 mold of Thundercracker, that's the one that I have.
That's what I've got, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I still have the first Starscream and the first Skywarp, though.
Because that Skywarp that you have is the one that has the hip panels, right? I mean, the hip wings?
Yes. Yeah, it's a Walmart.
Right.
A Walmart one. He
can have it.
Thundercracker's the Toys R Us exclusive, whatever.
I'll wait for the Toys R Us Skywarp.
Well, I wasn't going to sell it to you.
They both came in that plastic casing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It looked like a kind of a V-shaped thing kind of going.
Yeah.
Yep. Plastic clamshell thing.
I have that Skywarp,
but I like it. I like that Skywarp.
Box. I haven't opened them. They haven't been touched.
I just want all my sneakers look alike.
Yeah, I just never got around. I got that Skywarp for like, I think $10. They had so many at Walmart. They were trying to get them out, so I picked them up for like $10 at Walmart.
Scalper.
No, man, this was fucking shit. It was like 10 years ago at least. I was like, yep. 10 years from now, this one's going for big money. And Thundercracker, I picked up at Toys R Us when it came out. That's a good while back, too. Shit.
What was the resale on those back then?
Thundercracker would have probably been 60, maybe?
60. I thought it was like, 60, 70, maybe? Something like that.
Somewhere around there. Yeah. Under 100, I know that.
I paid 90 for mine. I think
so.
Secondhand.
Skywarp. They put Skywarp in. They had so many. Starscream also was a Walmart exclusive, and they sold good. The Starscream sold good, but that Skywarp sat there for. I mean, they had like the end caps just full of them, and they knocked them down. I think some people were even getting for like $5.
Wow,
dude!
Yeah, that was a massive piece for $5.
This was like 2007.
That's mind-boggling.
2008.
But then again, a lot of people didn't realize Wolf was beginning then, so they didn't grab them.
Yeah,
it was also a different size.
They didn't realize that this was the beginning of a line.
Yeah. What did you say? It was a different size. Yeah.
No. Well, I mean, like we got MP01, the Hasbro version. I saw that. I got that clearanced for like $20.
Yeah.
And it's like, what am I going to do with this thing? Because it's so huge.
It was.
And then you get the Starscream and Skywarp, and it's like, okay, so we're getting something else that's huge, but it doesn't fit and scale with the other one. So it was just kind of a mix and match type of thing.
Did you get into that weird ass box, like the 25th anniversary thing, whatever?
Yeah.
Yeah, they had tons of those. I picked mine up for like I think $30. They were trying to get them out too at Walmart. And it was,
wow.
They were just everywhere. I remember people going up and trying to get five or six of them, trying to scalp them and shit. I was like, I just want one. I just want one for my collection. Just let me have one. Be good.
Did you put it on the cafe yet, Deluxe?
No, I put it in. I haven't put it anywhere. I told y'all, and I had some people I chat with, but nobody's bit. So. Yeah. But I think Tommy said if he has somebody, I'll. I don't know. I have to ship to. Is it Canada? Hey, Tommy, the guy that you think wants to buy them, is he in Canada too?
Yeah, he lives in my city.
Okay.
There's a good $60.
About that customs. Yeah, $60-$70.
So how much? Wait, he's asking how much? How much? I didn't get.
Well, that. I didn't know. I was gonna just say the U.S. Sorry. No, I don't know if he wants to pay for shipping. I meant I was gonna do $250 ship, but I don't know how much it's gonna be for shipping over there.
So $250 for both of them U.S., right?
Here's a good. Yeah. Here's kind of an example. I sold that Sigma L, you know, the Mind Wipe fans project, and mm-hmm. to somebody in Canada, and it cost me $30 to ship that to Canada.
Ooh, that small one. Ooh.
Yeah, yeah. It's gonna be pricey to ship those things to Canada, man.
Yeah, they were pretty big.
$300.
$375 shipped. All right, $375 shipped. He said that.
Hey, Tommy, tell him if he wants to pay for shipping. Deluxe said he'd do it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah,
how
I'm
much.
Just waiting for.
You'll probably have to add like another like at least $50 like to the shipping.
Yeah, so it'd be like 300. God, yeah, 300 shipped at least.
You can go online too and kind of estimate it. If you weigh the box and measure it out, you can fill it out. It'll tell you on the USPS website.
Okay. I don't know how much they weigh at least. It'd be a good 2 pounds, maybe.
You gotta count for the box and the packing material, though, too.
Yeah.
Damn it, Chisk. Yeah.
Sorry, dude.
Versus bubble.
Yeah, probably about maybe 4 to 5 pounds, probably.
Hey, Deluxe will let you know as soon as he gets back to me.
Okay, that's fine. That's fine. If not, you know, I'll put them in the cafe, whatever.
He's been waiting for those ones. He's been looking for them, so. It's the only two he needs to finish off the Seekers, yeah.
I didn't know people wanted them. I've had them forever.
It's only because the Takara is so expensive. Like, that's something I'm looking for at TFCon, man. I'm just looking to see if somebody has the Takara, one that's for not insane.
Would you buy them opened? Would you buy them?
Yeah, I totally would. I mean, I'll buy it loose without a box if it saves me some money, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I got a guy, he's going to sell me Utopia for $200 ship.
Damn, dude, that's a deal.
Without the box. That's
wow.
Cool.
That's so cool.
Wow, that's excellent for that.
So that's why I'm trying to trade it, because I don't have that money right now. I was like, I had to have something in here that I could sell.
And 200 shipped.
You said this is the first time you're ever selling something?
Yes, it is, and I'm kind of scared.
You nervous?
Yeah, I am nervous. I've never sold anything, and I just, Yeah, and I've talked to my wife about it, and I'm just like, you know, kind of, she's like, have you put it up there? I'm like, no. She's like, are you even going to do it? I'm like, yes. And I was like, I've held back. I was supposed to do it last week, and I was like, I don't want to get rid of them. I don't know. Maybe because I'm a hoarder. I think I'm a hoarder.
Yeah. Welcome to the club.
A whore?
Hoarder of Transformers.
Dude, I would just bathe in your room right there. Victory. I would just... God, and I haven't even seen. I mean, how big is that room? I mean, because I've always see is that little space that you're in.
This room is the size of a, I don't know, it's not the size of a master bedroom, but it's a decent size.
Jeez.
And then my toy room is actually the size of a den.
Wait. You have another room?
That's just his box room, Deluxe.
This is my box room.
Yeah.
That's just where you box.
Boxes, games, comics, and. Yeah, that's about it.
I want to work where you work at, man. God,
I don't work.
Damn.
That's the sad thing.
You're a trust fund baby, huh?
I do, actually.
Damn. That's kind of dumb.
He's I worked for a while. Business for myself.
And
do
then
you have,
I, I got a trust one too, though. So.
Do you have your Do you have pictures of your collection? I know you do, right?
I did long time ago. It was like it's old.
He's stingy about putting them out there.
What?
Do you blame him?
You don't want people to know.
Oh, I'll start getting comments like Kenny Prime got with all my things. Like, hey, how much is that stuff? I'll buy that for you. I'll buy all that.
Yeah. I just want to see the collection. I don't want to buy anything. I just want to see
it. Yeah, so Black Panther.
So.
Well, I think that'll be Black Panther races.
I got some messages on IG from my Slug Slinger when I did that little video.
That was a cool idea, Tommy. I like that. That was cool.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
Someone wanted to buy it?
Yeah, a couple people had messaged me. A direct message me and ask me. So.
The body is not worth anything, but you can get a lot for that fucking Target Master.
Yeah. How can Dust just sleep like that? How could he sleep like that? That's how fucking out of the chair.
I'll shit you not. I'll sleep with that too if I could.
They were in the room with him so that they could put makeup on him, or is it just me?
No, I just caress him. I just hold him. That's a little baby. A little baby Dust.
You know, he got talent, though, because if that was me, my mouth would be all open. I'd be drooling, you know, snoring.
You gotta wonder if he's really asleep.
No, he's done.
He's definitely asleep.
He's done.
If you've ever seen the show before, you know.
Well, I've had him go to sleep on me before.
Does he got work? He doesn't have to work tomorrow, does he?
Usually, no. Usually he has Tuesdays off.
Okay, that's what I thought. Yeah, he's fell asleep a couple times.
It's like it gets hammered.
Usually it's after he turns off the live feed.
Oh, dude, yeah, like the first time, like when I started hanging out and stuff, and you see him, like, dude, he was there like 5 a.m. It's still just out.
He's gonna leave this shit on all night long live.
Yeah, he will until he wakes up. I mean, it won't see it.
And
like,
then he'll have to edit it.
He'll edit it out. He'll cut it all out. So if you're listening, Dust, right around the, I guess it doesn't matter, right around the 11:40 mark, you could probably stop it. But
oh shit, man, it's time. It's 11 o'clock. I only gotta work two more days.
Two more days? Oh, then your vacation?
I got a 4-day weekend. I took 2 days off.
Nice, dude. We doing anything special?
Little Rock Comic Con is this weekend.
Oh, sweet.
I'm gonna go up to there and hang out with some buddies.
They bring
I'm sorry.
Oh, so they bring celebrities in for that?
Yeah, they have. They've actually got bigger. Last year they had David Kay and Michael something. He did tracks in
McConaughey,
yeah. This year he has three Power Rangers, three of the older Power Rangers, and Jim, the voice of Jim.
Samantha Newark.
Yeah. So yeah, it's gotten pretty big. It used to be we was in a hotel, just a little room, and now he's has a convention center, and last 2 years he's gotten, you know, 2,000 people at least. So it's getting bigger. Yeah, that's cool. It's really cool. So I'm gonna go hang out with him. What's the finger banging this week?
It's Fans Toys Hound.
Oh, Hound. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. That's what I said. I said it to Bobby, then Bobby said it to Ace, and then Ace broke it.
What did he break?
No, the mirror, it was already breaking. Like Bobby said, his mirror was already breaking, but Ace officially broke it. It's like the rear view mirrors are on these little tiny pegs.
Yeah, I remember him saying that, yeah.
It should have been diecast.
Whose was it? It was yours originally?
It was mine. And then,
Are you going to make him pay for it? I would whoop his ass.
It's cool. It's, you know.
Passed around like a war.
It ain't no TSC hounds.
No, we'll see it, man. Now at this point, my only hope is that he really does snap the thing in half. That's the only saving grace for it.
Are you going to be getting another one?
Dude,
like an official release one?
It's good enough that I may get rid of my Make Toys Hound and buy just an official release of that. It's that damn good.
Nice.
Yeah, it's hard to say. I don't know. Once I get them both, well, I guess I had them both together.
Which transformation do you like the best?
Between the two?
Yeah.
I haven't messed with the Fans Toys enough, but the Fans Toys, even though the transformation is hard, it has less moving parts than the Make Toys one. Like, there's less panels and things you have to flip around.
Those accordion arms have me a little worried. Those are just, to me, those are places that can break easily.
Yeah, you do. I think that some people have broke it there, but that's cool just because that's just something new that you haven't seen in a while. But I'll tell you this. It's the difference between, you know, like when you, it's fan toys. The whole thing is metal. You know what I mean? So yeah. It's kind of like when you hold the bug. That's why I always tell everybody, like, if you ever buy if you ever get like a Baldwin drop, open up your fans toy stuff last, because you open that first, everything else feels just like shit afterwards, because they're so light. Like I got Bombshell, and then I got that Unique Toys Blur, and I was like, man, I should have just fucking opened the Blur first.
Yeah, I felt the same way, because I got those both at the same time.
So awesome. I'll open your fans toy stuff
Blur,
last.
I love that Blur, man. Oh, me too.
No, dude, it's awesome. But like, you know what I mean, when you feel it, you're like, oh man, it's not.
Yeah, it's lighter than the Insecticon. Hey, but did you get your Sunstreaker?
No, I'm Omnigon. After Robert's photos. Robert saved me.
He says he's gonna pass that shit around.
What's up?
I have a question for you.
Okay.
Will you officially say that the Bad Cube is better than the Omnigonix?
I can't officially. I mean, based on appearance. See, I don't know, man. The Omnigonix still, even though the chest is so fucking huge, I still like other things about it. The alt mode still looks better. The legs still look better to me. But, based on the fucking photos, like, I can't, man. If somebody's selling that thing for $50, I'll definitely buy it, but I'm not trying to spend $90 on that thing.
No.
I can't do it. Mm-mm. I did that with the... Like, that's the thing. I have the Voodoo Toys Ratchet, which I like. I think it looks better as Ratchet, but dude, the MP is just made so much better. It's hard to pass up on quality, man.
Yeah, and that Voodoo Toys is expensive. That's like a $120 figure, right?
Yeah, oh, dude, it's not. That thing should be $80.
Yeah, that's way overpriced.
Yeah, so it's not worth it. Like, and I want to get their Ironhide if they ever put it out, but it's not worth the cost.
I bet they go out of business.
Yeah,
I'm dude, they're one and done. Somebody had to justify their heroin habit, and was like, dude, let's just start a toy company.
Okay.
They're laundering money. That's what they. That was their product for that.
Oh, I gotta ask, Victory, do you have Black Zarek? Or Grand Maximus?
I have Black Zarek. I don't have Grand Maximus.
Damn. Is it complete? And what about the GPS?
There's like a one little spot that when I broke him out of the box, I looked at it, and it's on the shield. Just a little bit of the peg. It's just busted. Other than that, he's still in the box. I haven't touched him. He's just on the shelf.
Oh, God, I would love to have him.
Is that a G1 character? That's not a release or a third party, right?
It's a retooled version of Scorponok, but it's for Super God Master Force, the Japanese series.
Yeah, it was only It was only released in Japan. It wasn't released here.
When did it come out? The toy.
1988.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
88, 89. It's worth a lot of money because it's got a lot of glow plastic, a lot of syndrome, GPS, you know, the shield, the little fast track, I guess is that's name.
Yeah,
I think that's the name. The gun. I mean, a lot of it's gold plastic, and it's hard. Yeah, the headmaster. It's hard to find one complete that's not been, you know, jacked up.
Right.
Yeah.
Dude, I wish. Oh, go ahead.
No, go on. I'm done.
I would say I wish I had some of that. Like, I held on to stuff. As a kid, you know, like, I had Scorponok as a kid, and I wish I still fucking would have held on to it. I don't know what happened to it.
Yeah, I love my Scorponok. I have those base. I just, I would love to have a Grand Maximus. That's another trail.
What do they sell for?
They go to over 2,000.
Yeah, but 2 grand.
Holy shit.
And Black Zarek, he can go for probably 3,000 if he's in good condition and nothing.
Yeah.
It could easily go for $3,000 at least.
Jeez.
Yeah, I paid about, what was it, $1,300?
That's good.
$1,300 for Black Zarek.
What did you buy it, though? How long ago was that, though?
2 years ago.
Only two? Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, that's a real good deal.
Yeah. Shit. So I'm only 47 away from completing the entire Generation 1 line.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
That includes Japanese, European.
Jeez.
Congrats, man. That's awesome.
Wow. Nice.
Yeah, that I saw
one. G1 is America.
Yeah.
I saw one that I think they had one at TFCon last year, and he wanted, what did he want, 2,000 for it? But it was all wrapped up and everything. He didn't want to open it up.
Oh, yeah.
I'm good on that, man. I think he wanted 1,800, I think.
But it wasn't a mint in box, right? Like it was.
You saw that, right? Did you see he was sitting on top of his little stand? I forgot where it was. Well, no, you weren't there. I'm sorry.
No, yeah, I was like, oh, I didn't see that.
No, I'm sorry. Well, at TFCon, yeah, he had it up on top and everything. I think he had 1,800 for it, I think.
But I mean, it wasn't new, right? It wasn't mint in box or anything like that.
No.
So dude, then open that shit up, dude. Somebody's about to drop 2 G's and you're not going to open up the packaging?
I want, I Am Ratchet has a G1 Starscream graded, I think 85. I think he wants 1,800 for it. Wow. That'd be one of my holy grails to have right there.
Would you shadow box that?
Shadow box.
Mount it on your wall.
I don't know. I mean, I would just, you know, put them on regular star screens, you know. So you'd be my, you know, holy grail.
Hey, Deluxe, have you gotten the Grand Galvatron, the Transformers United Combiner Wars, as a ghost Starscream in there?
Oh, no. I do not. I'm not getting I think Garringer, he's getting it, and I think he's going to send me the Starscream.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't want to buy that set.
I want the
Starscream. I just don't think, and I probably could. I don't know. I don't know if I could find somebody that would have that separated, but there might be. But he said he asked me, like, you want that Ghost Starscream? I'm like, sure. He's like, yeah, I'm gonna get that Galvatron set. That set looks.
We were talking about that a couple of hangouts ago that we were saying, oh, Deluxe is going to have to buy that whole set just to get the Starscream.
it's a cool concept. I like the concept of it, you know, where, you know, they were all, you know, had to tie in with Galvatron and being killed and stuff. It's a great concept, but it's not a great set.
It's not $160. Great.
No. But, hell no. I mean, I got all the other ones. I'm done with Combiner Wars. I'm ready for Titan Wars. You know, come on. I want to see some new stuff. Yeah. I don't know. There's 13 Computrons out. I don't know. We have a new section in the SCU. You know, what Computron coming out this week?
So. Who else can
get one? You gonna get that Victorian?
No, I'm good. I'm good with that one. I think, are they in stores? I think somebody said they're in stores now.
People are seeing them at Target.
It looks so bad.
Like, if I see it, I probably want to get it.
Nah,
I'm good. No.
That's why you got to tell your wife, like, hey, look, do not let me buy this figure specifically.
Yeah, they're females.
Yeah, they're all female.
I'm on that one.
How much is, do you have that one?
No, I'll be getting it whenever I see it.
Oh. How much is he in the stores?
I think it goes for $100.
Mm.
Which I was surprised because being the set that it is, I thought it was going to go for a little bit more. So I was like, oh, okay.
It's, yeah, like 160 or something?
They probably couldn't move it. That's why they had to keep it low.
Maybe.
It'll definitely be 150 in our stores.
Are you going to pick it up, Barricade?
What's up?
You know what? I'm going to get it because Janae likes it.
That's cool.
Yeah.
She really likes it, so I'll get it because she wants it.
Dude, my kids could care less about some Transformers. Like, I open up Sludge today, and my son, he just, you know, he's 4. He's like, did it come with a shooter gun? You know, all he wants, he just likes
yes, to it did. It did.
Yeah, okay. He just wants to play with the guns. Yeah. Like, it's cool. I was like, yeah, here you go. Just run around.
Have you tried to put them onto, like, the cartoons and stuff?
They're not into it, man. But my son, like, so the Toy World, I think it's Mixmaster, comes with the gun for Devastator.
Yeah.
And that thing, dude, that was just like a regular, he loved that thing.
Huge.
Can I play with the purple one? I'm like, yeah, man, here you go. No, it's I don't mind.
It's a solid piece. He won't break it. You know, it's a solid piece. So.
It's just that. What'll end up happening is he'll scratch it because he's, you know, running around banging into stuff. And,
yeah.
But, I mean, if I'm just sitting in here and he's in here, it's like, yeah, dude, here you go. That's what he likes. Yeah, the guns and the swords could care less about the figures. Just wants the guns to run around in.
Hey, Tommy, have you bought any of the Japanese, whatever, Combatant Wars sets?
The Unite Wars?
Yeah, Unite Wars. Yeah, Unite Wars. Have you bought any of those?
I'm going to buy the Unite Wars Computron one. That's about it.
Yeah, I'm on that too.
But
yeah.
I like the color scheme on there. I think it just looks better. So
yeah, that would be the only one. And there's like three completely different molds, or two completely different molds.
Yeah. Yeah, like nose comb?
Yeah.
Or something?
Yeah, like, I'm going to pick that one up. That'll be my only Unite Warriors one I'll pick up.
The Bruticus don't look that bad either, but I got Bruticus already, so I'm like, eh, I'm good.
If I can get the blast off separate, like the groove is available now, like separate for defense, or if I can get the blast off, I'll be good with that. I don't want to buy the whole set again.
I don't even want that groove, man. Oh, Jesus. Because groove will have to be a leg, and when you put that on that fucking hot spot to combine it, it just looks fucking stupid. I don't like it. It just looks fucking awkward. The fuck was that?
Be safe, everyone.
I think that was bullshit. I mean, I know why Hasbro did it is to get, you know, more repaints out of it, but that's just bullshit. Yep. To fucking put a Rook or something, you know, and which Rook is not a bad figure. I mean, it was a standalone figure. It actually looks good. But to not, you know, put in, you know, Groove, I mean, come on, and they give you a little Legends one, I mean, come on.
Yeah.
I mean, show some love to your fans that buy this shit. I mean, come on now. We've been around for 30-plus years. I
guess it's a way to get that, like, you know, get you to buy that extra figure, I guess.
Yeah, it definitely was. Just like, whatever the Aerial Bots helicopter's name was. It's the same thing with him, you know what I mean?
The slingshot and the whole Wild Rider.
I can't wait for Masterpiece Alpha Bravo.
If they made a Masterpiece Alpha Bravo, I would buy it.
You know what's funny? I would have bought the Combiner Wars one anyway, but like just the fact that like they're making people that wouldn't have bought him normally, like, think that they had to or something. You know what I mean? It does kind of stink.
Yeah. It tied into the IDW comics, but it didn't last that long, which is dumb.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of people don't read the comics, so it's just like, you know. It's kind of a shady move, but, oh, whatever. We've been taking an ass off for fucking 30 years now. Might as well just get used to it.
They're not going to stop now.
Hell has, bro.
Just sticking it in deeper.
I got mad at a guy. I made a comment that I wish they weren't releasing as many Beast Wars this big year. He's Dark 30th with the movie. On one of the posting boards on CFW.
What about it now?
Huh?
Well, you know, they've said one, they've teased another, and they've rumored three others coming out this year.
Oh, Cheetor. Cheetor. Mm.
Yeah, put on Cheetor.
I mentioned, you know, we ought to be getting some love, too, because it's the 30th anniversary of the movie, so we ought to get some of our movie figures.
Nah, you know, this is what we need Beast Wars, man. Fuck
G1.
Mm. Nah, fuck
this is what
fuck
I'm afraid
G1.
Of. Transformers and a lot of other, you know, stuff that's been around for you know, 25 years. Things have been around for, you know, 25, 30 years, and they can't just keep reincarnating the same characters literally every single time. So yeah, when new stuff comes out, like Windblade, for instance, like a new character, like it's important that things like evolve and add to it instead of just the same things literally every time.
Fuck Windblade.
You've already into my garbage.
What I have read from a lot of Beast fans is G1 sucked. They shouldn't get any new toys. Fuck them.
Whoa.
Those are just excuses, probably.
I don't know what you're talking about, man, but you're going to get off this podcast, man. You're getting a little violent here, and I don't like that. I need safe space.
Kenny's getting aggressive.
Yeah, that's aggressive.
Somebody get the taser.
get the two. Yeah, I want to see these dwarves get a figure or two every year. I'd like to see them get a line all their own of masterpieces.
Oh, I can't wait for Beast Wars. Fuck yes. I don't care what anybody says. Oh, yes.
Well, I'm going to jump down that rabbit hole.
I'm pumped. I can't wait.
I'm in on that. I don't care. Mm. Yeah, well, I know they'll make the core characters probably, but
you know how. See,
I'm going to jump down that rabbit hole. I'm already sliding down it on the video front.
Like a cock. Nah, I mean, everything's gonna. I mean, everybody should. Every line should get their love. I mean, I don't know if anybody really likes Energon.
Yeah, exactly.
No, not Energon. I don't think so.
I like Energon.
I don't like the whole super length. I need a torso. I need a waist.
I think we actually talked about that on the show.
I think you should give love to the Beast Wars, though. Like, seriously, we've had G1 characters for how many fucking years? You know what I mean? I mean, it doesn't mean I'm gonna buy the fucking figures, but I mean, you guys need some fucking.
But there's a crowd for them. You know, there's
Yeah,
we'll see. I mean, we'll see how good they do. You know, if they don't sell, they won't make them. But I mean, I think they will sell pretty good. I think they'll do at least. Yeah. I think they'll do decently.
I think they'll do good enough. Where you look at, like, you know, just like some of the, you know, more obscure characters. You know, I know that they're repaints, but things like Clampdown, Rogue Ridge. You know what I mean? Like, they're just getting the money out of the mold. So I think they'll do better than those.
Those are characters. Dog shit. Those aren't just die clubs. Those are characters.
But they have feelings, asshole. I'm not saying anything bad about them, but like they're repaints molds that are made.
Well, we're short of a Tiger Tron. I mean,
Cheetor.
That's one.
I mean, if they really wanted to do Masterpiece right, they'd make them bigger. They'd Dino make Tiger Tron bigger. A little bit.
Dinobot
is one.
Megatron. I hope they make. I know they'll do a Waspinator. I hope they do Scorpion. Scorpionaut. Whatever. Scorpionaut.
That's a good character. Yeah. I love fucking Dinobot.
Pterosaur.
I'm Dinobot's really surprised. So good. I mean, I'm really surprised.
Oh, it's going to be a tough one to
make.
There
he is.
Oh. All right,
Dust.
What's up?
Dust.
Is he headbanging? Dust. He's headbanging.
Dust.
He's riveted up.
I think the Beast Wars is getting to him.
Just might maximize.
Dude, that was hilarious.
he looked like he was headbanging, man. I'm really surprised. I know Optimal Primal. I know he's a big character, but I'm really surprised they did not start with Dinobot. Because I think he was a big, big major character in that. So, but.
Yeah.
I can see why they did Prime. I mean, that first, but you know.
Yeah, they had to stick with the Primes of the Convoys first.
That's true. So I'm surprised that they're doing Cheetor next. Like, I thought they might do Dinobot.
It's a Beast Wars Bumblebee. What do you expect?
Yeah, the only reason I could think of.
Yes,
the other reason I think that they went with Cheetor 2 is if they did like Megatron, and then some people could be like, okay, I'll tap out after 2, you know what I mean? And then they wouldn't get the other one, so maybe that helps make the line more successful if they go like, all right, here's Primal, and then here's a couple other characters, and then here's Dinobot, or here's Megatron.
Well, yeah, wasn't Cheetor one of those characters, like back when it first came out? But the younger generation, that's what they kind of veered towards. Just like how when we were younger, it was kind of like the Bumblebee, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Kids like would relate to that a little bit more. That's, you know,
he was made after Bumblebee. He had OCD or some shit, and he just ran.
He thought he was the coolest. Run, Cheetor, run.
So, yeah,
look how fast I could go.
Yeah, he was basically their Bumblebee.
We get it, you're fast.
He was the Bumblebee of, you know, that generation, of the Beast Wars. So, yeah, I can understand why they're doing it now.
He had a little bit of Sunstreaker in him, too, a little vein.
Yeah, he was. Right? A little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit.
I like Rhinox.
Coincidence, they're all yellow.
Yeah, Rhinox was a good character. He was an Ironhide. I think he was like a big Ironhide. Kind of.
Ironhide Wheeljack. Make sure.
He was like a puppy dog, Ironhide. He could fuck you up if you wanted to.
Dust mites.
Dust
mites.
Yeah, he's a.
I want to see you naked, Dust.
He just starts undressing in his sleep.
I was kidding, oh shit! I was kidding. You better put your clothes back on.
He was like, he's close.
It would give a whole new meaning to the show called Hangout.
I got my pecker hanging out.
Hangout,
come on, man. Get your fat ass over here. I can see, they'll do at least the main characters, Rhinox, Dinobot, Cheetor.
Dust.
Maybe Snowcat.
Black Arachnia.
Well, they could just recolor fucking Cheetor to Snowcat.
Tigertron.
Or, yeah, it's Tigertron, sorry. Snowcat was Energon. I love some Energon, I don't give a fuck. Whatever.
See, but then you can start getting into the lines where the toys were a lot better, and they don't need updates as badly too. Like when they did the Star Saber one, when they had that vote, they had a lot of like newer stuff. Like, didn't they have the Galaxy Force Prime, like that you could have voted for, you know? And like, it's that toy. That's one of my favorite Optimuses right there. I don't think that you can make.
Well,
they already had
the winner for that shit. They didn't. That wasn't a vote. That was a. We already know what we're going to put out. We're just going to seem like we're going to let y'all. We're going to throw you a little bone, but it's not really that big.
You kind of like Fort Max.
Yeah, that was the funny thing. Fort Max was on the voting list.
Yeah,
masterpiece Fort Max. Really.
talking about the Titan Wars. Fort
so that Max. would only have been about 350 probably maybe. If they made a masterpiece Fort Max,
you'd have to like store them in the garage. You'd be so big.
Comes in installments. There you go. First installment.
Here's his leg.
Yeah, no doubt.
First it'll be your car payment, then it'll be your mortgage, and then we'll just take some of your credit cards.
Fort Max ruin everyone's marriages.
Yeah, I was about to say he'll be your divorce. He'll be your divorce, your reason for divorce as well.
But we can move into it, honey. Is that big? Screw the
mortgage. He's the transformation cog. Now where is that piece?
Screw the mortgage.
You know what scares me? They're doing Beast Wars. In 3 years, are they going to start doing Beast Machines?
No, I don't think it has the same type of following.
Yeah, it's not the same pop following.
They'll go convoys. They'll do Fire Convoy. They'll do Galaxy Convoy, probably.
Yeah. They'll go to Armada before they do Beast Machines, probably.
Or Animated, or even Transformers Prime.
Oh yeah, animated. That would be fucking awesome.
That'd be neat if they did another fucking Armada Unicron. That'd be fucking sweet.
What do you mean, a masterpiece or just the same?
Yeah, like a masterpiece one. That'd be fucking sweet.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Or Omega.
I still love the Unicron that we've got. I think that thing is awesome.
Yeah, I want to see Skylinks, MP Skylinks or MP Omega.
Dude, MP Omega? Oh, that thing would be awesome.
Shuttle mode you can actually put your MPs into?
Oh, shut your face.
Yeah.
Holy
shut
shit.
Your face. You can put Bumblebee. Well, that'd be big. I don't know. Well, you can put the cards in there, probably. A couple. One or two, maybe. At least a couple Bumblebees.
Oh, man. Motorized track, tank, all that.
Yeah, that's $500 right there.
Yeah, you buy the track separate. It's like a model train set, like in scale.
That shit's getting too expensive. Oh, yeah. Who's there? I know everybody's probably getting Pandea, or whatever name.
The Scorpion.
Jesus Christ!
I'm not in for it.
How big is that thing?
Utopia size.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's supposed to go with. Is Scorponok in Metroplex fight?
No.
Yeah, about 30 seconds of the final episode.
That was four.
Stop
minutes.
Lying to me.
Four Max, I'm sorry.
He said
so Scorponok was with Fort Max, so.
Yeah. When he Triptychon.
That would be sweet, too. I bet Triptychon's coming soon. Somebody's probably got her in the works.
You think Make Toys would do it?
Aren't they doing all of those?
Depends on how Scorponok
are they kidding?
Yeah, I thought their plan was to do all those big guys.
Man, Pandia's just got a lot of shit going on, man. He just... I don't know if that's going to be enjoyable to play with.
I mean, it looks good. It looks really good. It's just, you know, I think that's one of those things that you just got to take your time when you manipulate it. And,
yeah.
You listen, know, but it looks like something that would be fun to play with.
Something that big, like I'm messing around with this MP Magnus, and it's almost too big just to enjoy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw the Chosen Prime had it. I watched it, and I was like, man, that just got too much going on. I don't know.
There is, yeah, like I think there is a point where things get too big, and we might start be getting there with something like that.
Well, I want a Utopia, but and I don't think I would if I had to buy him full price. I don't think I want to get him. I'm just getting him because I'm getting him for a good price.
Yeah, I mean that thing looks great, but
yeah, I got the Generations one, and he's good enough. Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
What do you think we're gonna get that voting? What would we do? Vote on that Triptychon? Or Triptychon one that voted? Little Titan thing that they did. When do we think we're going to get that thing out? Or
that's 2017.
Yeah, the end of next year, right?
Yeah, since Fort Max is next, yeah, it'll be after him.
Probably supposed to be the end of 2017, I think it was saying.
And Triptychon, right? Triptychon one, right?
Yeah, Triptychon. Mm-hmm.
So what are they going to remold out of that?
Yeah, there's not much.
Giga Storm.
That's about it.
A Grimlock.
Unless they figure out how to retool them somehow into a Scorponok.
Yeah, a really bad Scorponok.
Yeah, that would be...
Don't give them ideas.
What if they come up with something completely different?
Gonna be like the Bayformer Scorponok look.
They may do that. You know what I mean? Like, look at how long it took for them to switch up Metroplex. You know, that's enough time, man, for IDW to create a character. Similar, you know, it'll be an Autobot version of something like
that. Don't make an Autobot after it. Yeah. Make an Autobot after it.
I bet they don't even put anything out. They just had that shit just for shits and giggles. Oh wow.
Hey guys, I got a message from Hanny. Listen to this. He just sent it to me. Ready?
Ready.
Worldwide shout out from the Agabus to all my RLC brethren. We really appreciate your support. We can't thank you guys enough.
You guys get it?
Aww. Oh, sweet.
That's cool. That's from Hanny, man, right there.
Nice.
That was sweet, man. That was good.
Yeah, that's cool.
Did it come out clear enough or no?
Need some money from us today.
Yeah.
Was that message clear enough? I don't know if it was.
I heard the end of it, but I've been cutting in and out. It's you know, on my end. Right. Like, so if I miss you guys, that's why. But I heard the end of it.
Yeah, that's cool, man.
He's over. No, yeah, he is.
No.
No, he's fighting on something.
Dust. Is he Sugar Ray Leonard?
Oh, Silver Age.
Yeah, you got a taste of something you don't like in that dream.
repeatedly falling downstairs.
Yeah, it's like, oh, cute.
Well, I think I was gonna order Kickback from Agabus, but I like Chosen Prime too. But I don't know. I think probably I don't know who's cheaper. It's probably about the same price. Probably.
What's Chosen Prime charging?
85. I think
it's cheaper
than Agabus?
I don't know.
No, Agabus is cheaper.
Yeah, Agabus is cheaper. I was going to say he gave it to me for 80.
Yeah, I got it for 80 as well. Shit.
I like Brandon, though.
No, I mean, you know, yeah, that's, I hear you, dude. Just got to go.
I just never ordered from Agabus, and I don't, you know, I never get shout-outs from Agabus, so, you know, screw him.
Dude, that's the first time that's the first time we ever had.
Okay, I'm just kidding. I never.
I got my hot rod from him.
He does same day shipping, bro. And if you do it, like, and if he ships priority, like, dude, you're getting it 2 days later. Like, seriously.
Really? Okay. Yeah. So I'll look into it.
Dude, I got it in 2 days, and I'm in Canada. done.
What'd you get? Kickback?
No, the latest one I got was the Ratchet. I got my
TV. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah, I saw that. Okay. Yeah, man. I'll look at his website and see what it is.
Dude, I'm telling you.
My hot rod was 3 days. That's only because somehow the zip code was changed to 90210, so it was on its way to California.
Why are you living in Beverly Hills, man?